Tipton, where you and the rest of your baseball team will be treated with the utmost respect and courtesy.
You Yankees stink! You're going down!
Yeah, but first, can you autograph my mitt?
And my ball?
Please, get out from behind there! No, no, not over the... Sorry about this. How many times have I told you not to disturb the guests?
2,708. But it never gets old. Thanks.
My pleasure, guys.
Sorry, dude. But this hand will never touch the hand of a Red Sox rival.
Not even if it has tickets to tomorrow's game in it?
I love you, you stinking Yankee! No, thanks!
Whoa, okay. Don't break the Yankee!
Team Daddy bought me for Hanukkah.
You should have seen the ball players back in my day. Like Babe Ruth. What a honk!
You knew Babe Ruth?
Sure. Who do you think first called him? Babe.
You know, I am sick of you guys. I mean, who cares about looks? Okay. What else is there? How about intelligence? Sense of humor, sweetness, a lot of creativity. Okay, if you're gonna do that, stop when I stop. You really care about all that junk? I know this guy, Gavin, who'd be perfect for you.
I'll set it up for tomorrow.
Glennon, that is so sweet.
Well, you guys have so much in common. He has bad skin, too.
Tons of blackheads.
I do not have any black... Oh!
It's a special magnifying mirror to enable it to detect potential pimples while still at a subatomic level.
So, Maddie... I give you a facial and do your hair for your date tomorrow. We can have a little spa day in my suite.
Oh, me too. I love to ski, spend, and spa. Anything that starts with S.
Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. It'll be so nice to just for once spend a day pampering myself instead of doing what the boys want to do.
Hey, Mom, we got 3 tickets so you can take us to the game tomorrow. Won't that be fun?
Not fun.
It would be an opportunity for you to bond with the boys.
Oh, I shudder just thinking about it. Ooh, see? Ooh, ooh, flashback.
The more you connect with them, the less of your stuff they'll break.
You really expect me to believe that?
No. Mr. Mosby, please, 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 please. Oh. I never get a day to myself, and the boys love you.
They love me?
No. But they would if you took them to a baseball game.
I can't believe that hotel guy won't take his own kids to the baseball game.
No, no, they're not my kids.
That's just not right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, but I hate baseball.
Now, that's just un-American.
Mm-hmm. You believe this guy? I guess you hate apple pie, too, huh, fella? And puppies. And your own mama.
Sir, I love my mama. I would love to take the kids to the game. What time's kickoff?
Oh, the boys will be so thrilled. Yes. No! Mr. Mosby at a baseball game? Those two things just don't go together. It's like Zack and homework. Or Cody and a date. Oh, come on, guys. He's really looking forward to going with you, and he loves you.
He loves us?
No. But he might if he spent more time with you. Please. I never get a day to myself, and I changed your diapers.
Oh, no, she's playing the diaper card again. You know, Mom, if we knew you were always going to pull that diaper thing, we would have just sat in it. Speak for yourself. Yeah, these seats are awesome.
Oh, this seat is filthy.
Well, we told you to dress casual.
This is casual. I'm wearing loafers. And my pocket square is linen, not silk.
And my jockey shorts are a cotton blend.
Sit down.
Okay, today's the day. I'm finally gonna catch my first ball. Or it'll bounce off your head, and while everybody rushes to stop the bleeding, I could pick it up like last time.
Should we be wearing protective headgear?
Mr. Mosby, when you were a kid, didn't you ever dream about catching a ball at Fenway Park?
No. Back then, the ballet was my life.
Gee, there's a surprise, huh?
I was just a kid in the chorus, but I aspired to someday being picked to dance the challenging yet coveted role of Nutcracker Prince.
So did you get to do it?
Alas, no. One nasty tethered ball accident shattered my big toe. Just so painful for me to talk about.
Try having to listen to it.
Hey, check out the lead Drumsky's taking. He's gonna steal.
You know, I read the Encyclopedia of Baseball last night.
All of it?
Well, you have to be informed. Don't want to appear the boob.
Too late.
Current research proves that stealing a base, while theatrical, is statistically inadvisable.
No, I'll tell you what's inadvisable. Shooting off your mouth when you don't know diddly.
Well, I'm sure this diddly is a fine fellow, but statistics do not lie. Sir, stealing that base would be a waste of your time.
Here we go.
Which tends to make it a little frizzy. A little?
You look like the bride of Frankenstein.
Are we done making fun of my hair?
Not quite.
Your hair looks funny. Your hair looks funny.
Okay, now I'm done.
Don't worry. By the time we're done, your blind date's gonna think you're gorgeous.
All right.
Man who gave us these tickets?
Another reason to hate the Yankees.
Zack, how could you be so rude?
Miss Manners, this is a baseball game. It's not your ballet class.
Mock me if you will, but I was the only boy amongst 20 pretty girls. Mama didn't raise no fool.
Slack.
Oh, not to worry. I can razz with the best of them. Hey, Yankee person! The shoelace is untied. It's not really. I'm just saying that as a ploy.
clever.
Ooh. You swing like a girl. You're weak. You'd never make it as a nutcracker.
That's telling him.
Mm-hmm.
And now, please rise for the seventh inning stretch.
Life.
Too bad we can't do it every day.
Well, you can't.
But I can. Yay!
Ow! Why'd you do that?
It stimulates the circulation in your forehead. Prevents wrinkles.
Oh. Okay. Ow! Ow. 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 Aren't you guys afraid of wrinkles?
Nah. When the time comes, I'm going to grow old gracefully.
Okay, Maddie, let's get started on your hair. You come over here and let's work some magic. For my first trick, I made the comb disappear. It'll be fine once we wash, condition, blow dry, straight iron, and possibly shave your head.
What?
I'm kidding.
As long as I stay inside. Otherwise, it's attack of the killer hair.
Then it was pretty smart of me to arrange your date here at the hotel. Look, I don't know why some people think I'm stupid.
Ow. 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 Ow.
It's a mystery, all right.
I do. Mr. Mosby, your hat's empty.
Ah! And refill it, boys. Hey, how about some peanuts?
Yeah!
Ah! Hey, waiter! Three orders of your finest peanuts, please.
And some cotton candy?
Sure. And some... Ooh!
Never mind.
Huh? Hey! Oh! Good thing I didn't order the canned ham.
I gotta say, Mr. Mosby... For a stick in the mud, you're okay.
And for a pain in the derriere, so are you.
This stinks. It's the bottom of the ninth, the socks are losing, and now we'll never catch a ball. It's not over yet. If he hits this, we still have a chance of winning.
Oh.
It's coming to us!
Oh, don't catch that!
I caught it for you.
No, thanks.
Oh, but I insist.
Keep it.
Oh, but you wanted one.
Not that one.
Why not?
And in appearance, the batter is out. Get keys wet.
That's why.
To think I shared popcorn with the likes of you.
Nice going, Mr. Mosby. You lost us the game. You are going to be the most hated man in Boston.
Bish, boss. I think you're blowing this all out of proportion.
Look.
Actually a giant tumbleweed.
London.
Gavin! This is Maddie. Maddie, this is Gavin.
Hi.
Hi. You know, for two smart people, you guys don't say very much.
That's because we are so smart we can communicate telepathically.
Oh, yeah? Oh, what's she saying? And don't talk.
Well, Maddie just said she thinks we're going to have a great time.
And Gavin just said he wishes you'd leave. Well, that's the rudest thing I've never heard.
Sir, your table is ready. Ah, well, if it isn't Little Miss... I'm sorry, but this hotel doesn't stock your favorite flavor of gum.
Patrick, no one likes coconut gum.
I do. So apparently, I'm a no one. This way.
Wait! No. We have to have a table inside. Please. St. Patrick.
So, I see. Now I'm a someone.
No, it's just it's really humid out there.
Yes, that would explain the lack of available tables in here.
We'll wait. How soon can you seat us inside?
Breakfast. Splendid decision. Right this way. Balmy, isn't it? Enough small talk. Here's your table. Here are your menus. Would you like some crayons?
Well, this isn't so bad. Will you excuse me for a second?
Hello? Carrie, this is a disaster. What's the matter? Is your date a dud?
Tell him your husband just got out of jail. Works for me every time.
No, he's great. But we're outside, it's 95% humidity, and I can hear my hair frizzing.
Thank goodness, sanctuary.
Traitor, how dare you show your face in here?
I'm the manager.
Well, Mr. Manager, I bet your mama don't love you now.
She did leave a nasty message on my cell phone.
If anyone asks, we don't know you. We just met you at the game, and we didn't hit it off.
What? We were having fun. We were bonding.
I'm sorry. Mom says not to talk to strangers.
Oh.
Oh, hi. How was the game?
Oh, fine, if you like being pelted by peanuts.
Great, glad you had fun.
I ran as fast as I could.
Not fast enough, he's growing!
No, it's okay, I got here in time.
In time for what?
In time to recommend the steak. It's fantastic.
Cool. Can we have some water, please?
I'm not a waitress.
Then who are you?
I'm a singer. I'm a singing chef. Enjoy your meal, try the steak, not the veal. I know.
It really is humid tonight, isn't it?
Is it? I hadn't noticed.
Excuse me.
I'll be right back.
I am not staying in any hotel managed by some Benedict Arnold.
Me neither. I'm checking out and I'm going to stay at the St. Mark. Blame me if you must, but please do not punish this magnificent hotel. I'd rather die.
Works for us.
Mr. Mosby, if I hadn't made such a big deal about never catching a ball, you probably wouldn't be in this fix. Yeah. We gotta do something. Yeah. Wanna go get some ice cream?
Sure. Sorry. Oh.
The hairspray's wearing off. I think I built up immunity to it.
It's a little frizzy.
How little?
Somewhere between a troll doll and an unsheared sheep.
Miss London, may I get you a table inside?
I thought you said there wasn't anything available inside.
I'm sorry, does your father own this hotel? I didn't think so.
Thank you, Patrick, but I just came up to check on my friend's date. Although I don't know why I should after you thought rude things to me.
Well, we apologize. Now, please, help me blot.
Got a lot?
That's why I need your help. See, I really like Maddie, which makes me a little nervous, so it makes me sweat even more. But I don't want her to see me sweating, so I have to keep running in here to blot, which makes me sweat more.
Ew. You take care of this.
Thanks. Hey, would you mind putting some deodorant on my back?
Come with me. It's not working! It's alive! I recommend the creme brulee.
I recommend you go away.
Look, you've both been hiding something. The truth is, how do I say this nicely? Maddie is a frizzy hair freak, and Gavin sweats like a donkey in a sauna. So now you guys can just relax and enjoy your date. I mean, if you can forget how hideous you both look. Oh, great. More smarty pants, silent talk. Okay, what are you guys saying?
I said that I love curly hair.
And I said that a little perspiration never hurt anybody.
Oh, this is so romantic. In an incredibly icky kind of way. Now what are you saying?
Gavin wants to thank you for setting up our date and then saving it.
Oh.
And Maddie wants you to leave.
Do you know what I'm thinking up here?
Nothing.
Wow, you guys are good.
I just hope Mr. Mosby's okay. Well, if you're so concerned, why don't you just ask him? Mr. Mosby!
There he is! Oh, my God!
How does it feel to be the most hated man in Boston?
I didn't mean to cost the Sox their game.
Do you think you'll have to leave Boston?
Leave Boston? He should leave the country.
He didn't deserve this. Hold my cone. I'm going in.
Leave him alone.
Who are you?
I'm the kid he took to the game.
I don't know either of them.
Why'd you pull such a bonehead move?
He couldn't help doing something incredibly stupid. It was his first game.
Wait, a grown man who's never been to a baseball game?
Yeah.
It's not his fault his mom made him wear tights and play ballet.
Actually, I quite enjoyed the dancing. But you go ahead.
That would have been the smartest move. But he caught that ball for me. For a kid who always dreamed of catching one. But was too lame to do it himself. Because he has lousy hand-eye coordination. I have astigmatism. Look. Don't you all remember what it was like to go to your first baseball game? To walk through that dark tunnel and suddenly see the stadium open up in front of you? Smelling the newly cut grass and the fresh roasted peanuts. The fat fans' nacho burps. The point is, this man didn't think he'd like baseball. But once he got there, he loved it. So we got swept away in the excitement and caught the ball. He did it for me. He may be the most hated man in Boston, but to me, he's a hero.
Well, you know, the kid's got a point.
Yeah. And isn't that what baseball's all about? Not winning or losing, but the love of the game?
Yeah.
Not if you lost your paycheck betting on the Sox.
You got that right. And it knocked us out of first place.
Behind the Yankees.
I hate the Yankees.
I hate him.
Get him!
Yeah! Run, boys, run!
mentioned every 5 minutes for the last hour and a half, but who's counting? It's closing time.
Isn't it just a gorgeous night?
Absolutely perfect.
Okay, fine. If you want to stay, I have one favor to ask. We've run out of steel wool in the kitchen. We'd love to scrub the pots out with your hair.
I was just a kid in the chorus, but I aspired to someday being picked to dance the challenging yet coveted role of Nutcracker Prince.
So did you get to do it?
Alas, no. One nasty tethered ball accident shattered my big toe. Just so painful for me to talk about.
Try having to listen to it.
Hey, hey! Check out the lead Drumsky's taking. He's gonna steal.
You know, I read the Encyclopedia of Baseball last night.
All of it?
Well, you have to be informed. Don't want to appear the boob.
Too late.
Current research proves that stealing a base, while theatrical, is statistically inadvisable.
No, no, I'll tell you what's inadvisable. Shooting off your mouth when you don't know diddly.
Well, I'm sure this diddly is a fine fellow. But statistics do not lie. Sir, stealing that base would be a waste of your time.
There he goes.
Hair. It's humid outside, which tends to make it a little frizzy.
A little?
You look like the bride of Frankenstein. Are we done making fun of my hair?
Not quite.
Your hair looks funny. Your hair looks funny. Okay, now I'm done.
Don't worry. By the time we're done, your blind date's gonna think you're gorgeous.
Oh.
The nice man who gave us these tickets?
Another reason to hate the Yankees.
Zack, how could you be so rude?
Miss Manners, this is a baseball game. It's not your ballet class.
Mock me if you will, but I was the only boy amongst 20 pretty girls. Mama didn't raise no fool.
Slack.
Oh, not to worry. I can razz with the best of them. Hey, Yankee person! The shoelace is untied! It's not really. I'm just saying that as a ploy.
Clever.
You swing like a girl! You're weak! You'd never make it as a nutcracker!
Mm-hmm.
And now, please rise for the seventh inning stretch.
Ooh. Level. So, Maddie, how about I give you a facial and do your hair for your date tomorrow? We can have a little spa day in my suite.
Oh, me too.
I love to ski, spend, and spa. Anything that starts with S. Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. It'll be so nice to just for once spend a day pampering myself instead of doing what the boys want to do.
Hey, Mom, we got 3 tickets so you can take us to the game tomorrow. Won't that be fun?
Not fun.
It would be an opportunity for you to bond with the boys.
Oh, I shudder just thinking about it. Ooh, see? Ooh, oh, flashback.
The more you connect with them, the less of your stuff they'll break.
You really expect me to believe that?
No. Mr. Mosby, please, 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 please. Oh. I never get a date of myself and the boy.
boys love you.
They love me?
No. But they would if you took them to a baseball game.
I can't believe that hotel guy won't take his own kids to the baseball game.
No, no, they're not my kids.
That's just not right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, but I hate baseball. Now, that's just un-American.
Mm-hmm. You believe this guy? I guess you hate apple pie, too, huh, fella? And puppies. And your own mama.
Sir, I love my mama. I would love to take the kids to the game. What time's kickoff?
Oh, the boys will be so thrilled. Yes. No! Mr. Mosby at a baseball game? Those two things just don't go together. It's like Zack and homework. Poor Cody and a date. Come on, guys. He's really looking forward to going with you, and he loves you.
He loves us?
No. But he might if he spent more time with you. Please. I never get a day to myself, and I changed your diapers.
Oh, no. She's playing the diaper card again. You know, Mom, if we knew you were always going to pull that diaper thing, we would have just sat in it.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah, these seats are awesome.
Oh, this seat is filthy.
Well, we told you to dress casual.
This is casual. I'm wearing loafers. And my pocket square is linen, not silk.
And my jockey shorts are a cotton blend.
Sit down.
Okay. Today's the day. I'm finally gonna catch my first ball. Or it'll bounce off your head, and while everybody rushes to stop the bleeding, I could pick it up like last time.
Should we be wearing protective headgear?
Mr. Mosby, when you were a kid, didn't you ever dream about catching a ball at Fenway Park?
No. Back then, the ballet was my life.
Gee, there's a surprise, huh?
Okay. Amazing. I mean, no one would know it's actually a giant tumbleweed.
London.
Gavin. This is Maddie. Maddie, this is Gavin.
Hi.
Hi. Well, you know, for two smart people, you guys don't say very much.
That's because we're so smart we can communicate telepathically.
Oh, yeah? Oh, what's she saying? And don't talk.
Well, Maddie just said she thinks we're going to have a great time.
And Gavin just said he wishes you'd leave. Well, that's the rudest thing I've never heard.
Sir, your table is ready.
Well, if it isn't Little Miss... I'm sorry, but this hotel doesn't stock your favorite flavor of gum.
Patrick, no one likes coconut gum.
I do. So apparently, I'm a no one. This way.
Wait! No. We have to have a table inside. Please. St. Patrick.
So, I see. Now I'm a someone.
No, it's just it's really humid out there.
Yes, that would explain the lack of available tables in here.
We'll wait. How soon can you seat us inside?
Breakfast. Splendid decision. Right this way. Balmy, isn't it? Enough small talk. Here's your table. Here are your menus. Would you like some crayons?
This isn't so bad. Will you excuse me for a second?
Hello? Carrie, this is a disaster.
What's the matter? Is your date a dud?
your husband just got out of jail works for me every time.
No, he's great. But we're outside, it's 95% humidity, and I can hear my hair frizzing.
Thank goodness, sanctuary.
Traitor, how dare you show your face in here?
Oh, but I'm the manager.
Well, Mr. Manager, I bet your mama don't love you now.
She did leave a nasty message on my cell phone.
If anyone asks, we don't know you. We just met you at the game, and we didn't hit it off.
What? We were having fun. We were bonding.
I'm sorry. Mom says not to talk to strangers.
Oh.
Oh, hi. How was the game?
Oh, fine, if you like being pelted by peanuts.
Great. Glad you had fun.
I ran as fast as I could.
Stay up, you blood-sucking leeches! Welcome to the Tipton. Where you and the rest of your baseball team will be treated with the utmost respect and courtesy.
You Yankees stink! You're going down!
Yeah, but first, can you autograph my mitt?
And my ball?
Please, get out from behind there. No, no, not over the...
I'm sorry about this.
How many times have I told you not to disturb the guests?
2,708. But it never gets old. Thanks.
My pleasure, guys.
Sorry, dude. But this hand will never touch the hand of a Red Sox rival.
Not even if it has tickets to tomorrow's game in it?
I love you, you stinking Yankee! No,
thanks! Well, okay. Don't break the Yankee!
Team Daddy bought me for Hanukkah.
You should have seen the ball players back in my day. Like Babe Ruth. What a honk!
You knew Babe Ruth?
Sure. Who do you think first called him? Babe.
Lou, I am sick of you guys. I mean, who cares about looks? Okay. What else is there? How about intelligence? Sense of humor, sweetness, a lot of creativity. Okay, if you're gonna do that, stop when I stop. You really care about all that junk? I know this guy, Gavin, who'd be perfect for you.
I'll set it up for tomorrow.
Glennon, that is so sweet.
Well, you guys have so much in common. He has bad skin, too.
Tons of blackheads. I do not have any black... Oh! It's a special magnifying mirror to enable it to detect potential pimples while still at a subatomic...
Isn't this a life?
Too bad we can't do it every day. Well, you can't, but I can. Yay!
Ow! Where'd you do that?
It stimulates the circulation in your forehead. Prevents wrinkles.
Oh, okay. Ow! Ow. 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 Aren't you guys afraid of wrinkles?
Nah.
When the time comes, I'm gonna grow old gracefully.
Okay, Maddie, let's get started on your hair. You come over here and let's work some magic. For my first trick, I made the comb disappear. It's okay. It'll be fine once we wash, condition, blow dry, straight iron, and possibly shave your head.
What?
I'm kidding. As long as I stay inside. Otherwise, it's attack of the killer hair.
Then it was pretty smart of me to arrange your date here at the hotel. Look, I don't know why some people think I'm stupid.
Ow. 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 It's a mystery, all right.
You tell him, Fancy Pants.
Oh, thanks, Artie. Hey, the popcorn?
Yeah, I don't mind if I do.
Mr. Mosby, your hat's empty.
And refill it, boys. Hey, how about some peanuts?
Yeah.
Hey, waiter, 3 orders of your finest peanuts, please.
And some cotton candy?
Sure, and some... Ooh.
Never mind.
Huh? Hey! Oh! Good thing I didn't order the canned ham.
I gotta say, Mr. Mosby, for a stick in the mud, you're okay.
And for a pain in the derriere, so are you.
This stinks. It's the bottom of the knife, the socks are losing, and now we'll never catch a ball. It's not over yet. If he hits this, we still have a chance of winning.
Oh.
It's coming to us!
Oh, don't catch that!
No!
Oh, hey! I caught it! I caught it for you.
No, thanks.
Oh, but I insist.
Keep it.
Oh, but you wanted one.
Not that one. Why not?
And in appearance, the banner is out. Get Keys wet.
That's why.
To think I shared popcorn with the likes of you.
Nice going, Mr. Mosby. You lost us the game. You are going to be the most hated man in Boston.
Pish, boss. I think you're blowing this all out of proportion.
Look. Homework. For Cody and a date.
Oh, come on, guys. He's really looking forward to going with you, and he loves you.
He loves us?
No. But he might if he spent more time with you. Please. I never get a date of myself, and I changed your diapers.
Oh, no. She's playing the diaper card again. You know, Mom, if we knew you were always going to pull that diaper thing, we would have just sat in it. Speak for yourself.
Oh, this seat is filthy.
Well, we told you to dress casual.
This is casual. I'm wearing loafers. And my pocket square is linen, not silk.
And my jockey shorts are a cotton blend.
Sit down.
Okay, today's the day. I'm finally gonna catch my first ball. Or it'll bounce off your head, and while everybody rushes to stop the bleeding, I could pick it up like last time.
Should we be wearing protective headgear?
Mr. Mosby, when you were a kid, didn't you ever dream about catching a ball at Fenway Park?
No. Back then, the ballet was my life.
Gee, there's a surprise, huh?
We'll be right back.
look okay? Amazing. I mean, no one would know it's actually a giant tumbleweed.
London.
Gavin. This is Maddie. Maddie, this is Gavin.
Hi.
Hi. You know, for two smart people, you guys don't say very much.
That's because we're so smart, we can communicate telepathically.
Oh, yeah? Oh, what'd she say? And don't talk.
Well, Maddie just said she thinks we're going to have a great time.
And Gavin just said he wishes you'd leave. Well, that's the rudest thing I've never heard.
Sir, your table is ready.
Ah, well, if it isn't Little Miss... I'm sorry, but this hotel doesn't stock your favorite flavor of gum.
Patrick, no one likes coconut gum.
I do. So apparently, I'm a no one. This way.
Wait. No. We have to have a table inside. Please. St. Patrick.
So, I see. Now I'm a someone.
No, it's just it's really humid out there.
Yes, that would explain the lack of available tables in here.
We'll wait. How soon can you seat us inside?
Breakfast. Splendid decision.
Right this way. Balmy, isn't it?
Enough small talk. Here's your table. Here are your menus. Would you like some crayons?
Well, this isn't so bad. Will you excuse me for a second?
Hello? Carrie, this is a disaster.
What's the matter? Is your date a dud?
Tell him your husband just got out of jail. Works for me every time.
No, he's great. But we're outside, it's 95% humidity, and I can hear my hair frizzing.
Thank goodness, sanctuary.
Traitor, how dare you show your face in here?
Oh, I'm the manager.
Well, Mr. Manager, I bet your mama don't love you now.
She did leave a nasty message on my cell phone.
If anyone asks, we don't know you. We just met you at the game, and we didn't hit it off.
What? We were having fun. We were bonding.
I'm sorry. Mom says not to talk to strangers.
Oh.
Oh, hi. How was the game?
Oh, fine, if you like being pelted by peanuts.
Great, glad you had fun. I ran as fast as I could.
Stay up, you blood-sucking leeches! Welcome to the Tipton. Where you and the rest of your baseball team will be treated with the utmost respect and courtesy.
You Yankees stink! You're going down!
Yeah, but first, can you autograph my mitt and my ball?
Please, get out from behind there! No, not over the...
So sorry about this.
How many times have I told you not to disturb the guests?
2,708. But it never gets old. Thanks.
My pleasure, guys.
Sorry, dude. But this hand will never touch the hand of a Red Sox rival.
Not even if it has tickets to tomorrow's game in it?
I love you, you stinking Yankee! Yeah, thanks!
Whoa, okay. Don't break the Yankee!
Just me and you know what to do, so come on down.
Team Daddy bought me for Hanukkah.
You should have seen the ball players back in my day. Like Babe Ruth. What a honk!
You knew Babe Ruth?
Sure. Who do you think first called him? Babe.
You know, I am sick of you guys. I mean, who cares about looks?
Stay up, you blood-sucking leeches!
Welcome to the Tipton, where you and the rest of your baseball team will be treated with the utmost respect and courtesy.
You Yankees stink! You're going down!
Yeah, but first, can you autograph my mitt?
And my ball?
Please, get out from behind there! No, no, not over the...
I'm sorry about this.
How many times have I told you not to disturb the guests?
2,708. But it never gets old. Thanks.
My pleasure, guys.
Sorry, dude. But this hand will never touch the hand of a Red Sox rival.
Not even if it has tickets to tomorrow's game in it?
I love you, you stinking Yankee! Yes,
thanks! Well, okay. Don't break the Yankee!
Team Daddy bought me for Hanukkah.
You should have seen the ball players back in my day. Like Babe Ruth.
What a honk!
You knew Babe Ruth?
Sure. Who do you think first called him? Babe.
You know, I am sick of you guys. I mean, who cares about looks? Okay. What else is there? How about intelligence? Sense of humor, sweetness, a lot of creativity. Okay, if you're gonna do that, stop when I stop. You really care about all that junk? I know this guy, Gavin, who'd be perfect for you.
I'll set it up for tomorrow.
Glennon, that is so sweet.
Well, you guys have so much in common. He has bad skin, too.
Tons of blackheads.
I do not have any black... Oh! It's a special magnifying mirror to enable it to detect potential pimples while still at a subatomic level. So, Maddie... How about I give you a facial and do your hair for your date tomorrow? We can have a little spa day in my suite.
Oh, me too.
I love to ski, spend, and spa. Anything that starts with S. Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. It'll be so nice to just for once spend a day pampering myself instead of doing what the boys want to do.
Hey, Mom, we got three
tickets so you could take us to the game tomorrow. Won't that be fun?
Not fun.
It would be an opportunity for you to bond with the boys.
Oh, I shudder just thinking about it. Ooh, see? Ooh, ooh, flashback.
The more you connect with them, the less of your stuff they'll break.
You really expect me to believe that?
No. Mr. Mosby, please, 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 please! Oh. I never get a day to myself, and the boys love you.
They love me?
No. But they would if you took them to a baseball game.
I can't believe that hotel guy won't take his own kids to the baseball game.
No, no, they're not my kids.
That's just not right.
Mm. Oh, no, but I hate baseball. Now, that's just un-American.
Mm-hmm. You believe this guy? I guess you hate apple pie, too, huh, fella? And puppies. And your own mama.
Sir, I love my mama. I would love to take the kids to the game. What time's kickoff?
Oh, the boys will be so thrilled. Yes.
No! Mr. Mosby at a baseball game? Those two things just don't go together. It's like Zack and homework. Or Cody and a date.
Come on, guys. He's really looking forward to going with you, and he loves you.
He loves us?
No. But he might if he spent more time with you. Please. I never get a day to myself, and I changed your diapers.
Oh, no. She's playing the diaper card again. You know, Mom, if we knew you were always going to pull that diaper thing, we would have just sat in it. Speak for yourself. These seats are awesome.
Oh, this seat is filthy.
Well, we told you to dress casual.
This is casual. I'm wearing loafers. And my pocket square is linen, not silk.
And my jockey shorts are a cotton blend.
Sit down.
Okay. Today's the day. I'm finally gonna catch my first ball. Or it'll bounce off your head, and while everybody rushes to stop the bleeding, I could pick it up like last time.
Should we be wearing protective headgear?
Mr. Mosby, when you were a kid, didn't you ever dream about catching a ball at Fenway Park?
No. Back then, the ballet was my life.
Gee, there's a surprise, huh?
I was just a kid in the chorus, but I aspired to someday being picked to dance the challenging yet coveted role of Nutcracker Prince.
So did you get to do it?
Alas, no. One nasty tethered ball accident shattered my big toe. Just so painful for me to talk about.
Try having to listen to it.
Hey! Check out the lead Drumsky's taking. He's gonna steal.
You know, I read the Encyclopedia of Baseball last night.
All of it?
Well, you have to be informed. Don't want to appear the boob.
Too late.
Current research proves that stealing a base, while theatrical, is statistically inadvisable.
No, no, I'll tell you what's inadvisable. Shooting off your mouth when you don't know diddly.
Well, I'm sure this diddly is a fine fellow. But statistics do not lie. Sir, stealing that base would be a waste of your time.
There he goes.
Hair. It's humid outside, which tends to make it a little frizzy. A little? You look like the bride of Frankenstein.
Are we done making fun of my hair?
Not quite.
Your hair looks funny. Your hair looks funny. Okay, now I'm done.
Don't worry. By the time we're done, your blind date's gonna think you're gorgeous.
All right.
The nice man who gave us these tickets?
Another reason to hate the Yankees.
Zack, how could you be so rude?
Miss Manners, this is a baseball game. It's not your ballet class.
Mock me if you will, but I was the only boy amongst 20 pretty girls. Mama didn't raise no fool.
Slack.
Oh, not to worry. I can razz with the best of them. Hey, Yankee person! The shoelace is untied!
It's not really. I'm just saying that as a ploy.
Clever.
You swing like a girl! You're weak! You never make it as a nutcracker!
Mm-hmm. And now, please rise for the seventh inning stretch.
Oh. Isn't this a life?
Too bad we can't do it every day. Well, you can't. But I can. Yay!
Ow! Where'd you do that?
It stimulates the circulation in your forehead. Prevents wrinkles.
Oh. Okay. Ow! Ow. 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 Aren't you guys afraid of wrinkles?
Nah. When the time comes, I'm gonna grow old gracefully.
Okay, Maddie, let's get started on your hair. You come over here and let's work some magic. For my first trick, I made the comb disappear. It'll be fine once we wash, condition, blow dry, straight iron, and possibly shave your head.
What?
I'm kidding.
As long as I stay inside. Otherwise, it's attack of the killer hair.
Then it was pretty smart of me to arrange your date here at the hotel. Look, I don't know why some people think I'm stupid.
Ow. 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 Ow.
It's a mystery, all right.
I do.
Mr. Mosby, your hat's empty.
Ah! And refill it, boys. Hey, how about some peanuts?
Yeah!
Ah! Hey, waiter! 3 orders of your finest peanuts, please.
And some cotton candy?
Sure. And some... Ooh!
Never
mind. Huh? Hey! Oh! Good thing I didn't order the canned ham.
I gotta say, Mr. Mosby... For a stick in the mud, you're okay.
And for a pain in the derriere, so are you.
This stinks. It's the bottom of the ninth, the socks are losing, and now we'll never catch a ball. It's not over yet. If he hits this, we still have a chance of winning.
Oh.
It's coming to us!
Oh, don't catch that! I caught it for you.
No, thanks.
Oh, but I insist.
Keep it.
Oh, but you wanted one.
Not that one.
Why not?
And in appearance, the batter is out. Yankees win.
That's why.
To think I shared popcorn with the likes of you.
Nice going, Mr. Mosby. You lost us the game. You are
Bish Bosser, I think you're blowing this all out of proportion.
Look. Does my hair look okay? Amazing. I mean, no one would know it's actually a giant tumbleweed.
London.
Gavin! This is Maddie. Maddie, this is Gavin.
Hi.
Hi. You know, for two smart people, you guys don't say very much.
That's because we are so smart, we can communicate telepathically.
Oh, yeah? Oh, what's she saying? And don't talk.
Well, Maddie just said she thinks we're going to have a great time.
And Gavin just said he wishes you'd leave. Well, that's the rudest thing I've never heard.
Sir, your table is ready.
Ah, well, if it isn't Little Miss... I'm sorry, but this hotel doesn't stock your favorite flavor of gum.
Patrick, no one likes coconut gum.
I do. So apparently, I'm a no one. This way.
Wait. No. We have to have a table inside. Please. St. Patrick.
So, I see. Now I'm a someone.
No, it's just it's really humid out there.
Yes, that would explain the lack of available tables in here.
We'll wait. How soon can you seat us inside?
Breakfast. Splendid decision. Right this way. Balmy, isn't it? Enough small talk. Here's your table. Here are your menus. Would you like some crayons?
Well, this isn't so bad. Will you excuse me for a second?
Hello?
Carrie, this is a disaster.
What's the matter? Is your date a dud?
Tell him your husband just got out of jail. Works for me every time.
No, he's great. But we're outside, it's 95% humidity, and I can hear my hair frizzing.
Thank goodness, sanctuary.
Traitor, how dare you show your face in here?
But I'm the manager.
Well, Mr. Manager, I bet your mama don't love you now.
She did leave a nasty message on my cell phone.
If anyone asks, we don't know you. We just met you at the game, and we didn't hit it off.
What? We were having fun. We were bonding.
I'm sorry. Mom says not to talk to strangers.
Oh.
Oh, hi. How was the game?
Oh, fine, if you like being pelted by peanuts.
Great. Glad you had fun.
I ran as fast as I could.
Not fast enough, it's growing!
No, it's okay, I got here in time.
In time for what?
In time to recommend the steak. It's fantastic.
Cool. Can we have some water, please?
I'm not a waitress.
Then who are you?
I'm a singer. I'm a singing chef. Enjoy your meal, try the steak, not the veal. I know.
It really is humid tonight, isn't it?
Is it? I hadn't noticed. Excuse me.
I'll be right back.
I'm not staying in any hotel managed by some Benedict Arnold.
Me neither. I'm checking out and I'm going to stay at the St. Mark.
Blame me if you must, but please do not punish this magnificent hotel. I'd rather die.
Works for us.
Mr. Mosby, if I hadn't made such a big deal about never catching a ball, you probably wouldn't be in this fix. Yeah. We gotta do something. Yeah. Wanna go get some ice cream? Sure.
Sorry. Oh. The hairspray's wearing off. I think I built up immunity to it.
It's a little frizzy.
How little? Somewhere between a troll doll and an unsheared sheep.
Miss London. May I get you a table inside?
I thought you said there wasn't anything available inside.
I'm sorry, does your father own this hotel? I didn't think so.
Thank you, Patrick. But I just came up to check on my friend's date. Although I don't know why I should after you thought rude things to me.
Well, we apologize. Now, please, help me blot.
Got a lot?
That's why I need your help. See, I really like Maddie, which makes me a little nervous, so it makes me sweat even more. But I don't want her to see me sweating, so I have to keep running in here to blot, which makes me sweat more.
Ew. You take care of this.
Thanks. Hey, would you mind putting some deodorant on my back?
Come with me. That's not working! It's alive! I recommend the creme brulee.
I recommend you go away.
Look, you've both been hiding something. The truth is, how do I say this nicely? Maddie is a frizzy hair freak, and Gavin sweats like a donkey in a sauna. So now you guys can just relax and enjoy your date. I mean, if you can forget how hideous you both look. Oh, great. More smarty pants, silent talk. Okay, what are you guys saying?
I said that I love curly hair.
And I said that a little perspiration never hurt anybody.
Oh, this is so romantic. In an incredibly icky kind of way. Now what are you saying?
Gavin wants to thank you for setting up our date and then saving it.
Oh.
And Maddie wants you to leave.
Do you know what I'm thinking up here?
Nothing.
Wow, you guys are good.
I just hope Mr. Mosby's okay. Well, if you're so concerned, why don't you just ask him? Mr. Mosby!
There he is! Oh, my God!
How does it feel to be the most hated man in Boston?
I didn't mean to cost the Sox their game.
Do you think you'll have to leave Boston?
Leave Boston? He should leave the country.
He didn't deserve this. Hold my cone. I'm going in.
Leave him alone!
Who are you?
I'm the kid he took to the game.
I don't know either of them.
Why'd you pull such a bonehead move?
He couldn't help doing something incredibly stupid. It was his first game.
Wait, a grown man who's never been to a baseball game?
Yeah.
It's not his fault his mom made him wear tights and play ballet.
Actually, I quite enjoyed the dancing. But you go ahead.
That would have been the smartest move. But he caught that ball for me. For a kid who always dreamed of catching one. But was too lame to do it himself. Because he has lousy hand-eye coordination. I have astigmatism. Look, was like to go to your first baseball game? To walk through that dark tunnel and suddenly see the stadium open up in front of you? Smelling the newly cut grass and the fresh roasted peanuts. Fat fans, nacho burps. The point is, this man didn't think he'd like baseball, but once he got there, he loved it. So we got swept away in the excitement and caught the ball. He did it for me. He may be the most hated man in Boston, but to me, he's a hero.
Well, you know, the kid's got a point.
Yeah. And isn't that what baseball's all about? Not winning or losing, but the love of the game?
Yeah. Not if you lost your paycheck betting on the Sox.
You got that right. And it knocked us out of first place.
Behind the Yankees.
I hate the Yankees.
I hate him.
Get him!
Yeah! Run, boys, run!
As I may have mentioned every 5 minutes for the last hour and a half, but who's counting? It's closing time.
Isn't it just a gorgeous night?
Absolutely perfect.
Okay, fine. If you want to stay, I have one favor to ask. We've run out of steel wool in the kitchen. We'd love to scrub the pots out with your hair.
I was just a kid in the chorus, but I aspired to someday being picked to dance the challenging yet coveted role of Nutcracker Prince.
So did you get to do it?
Alas, no. One nasty tethered ball accident shattered my big toe. Just so painful for me to talk about.
Try having to listen to it.
Hey! Check out the lead Drumsky's taking. He's gonna steal.
You know, I read the Encyclopedia of Baseball last night.
All of it?
Well, you have to be informed. Don't want to appear the boob.
Too late.
Current research proves that stealing a base, while theatrical, is statistically inadvisable.
No, no, I'll tell you what's inadvisable. Shooting off your mouth when you don't know diddly.
Well, I'm sure this diddly is a fine fellow. But statistics do not lie. Sir, stealing that base would be a waste of your time.
There he goes.
Hair. It's humid outside, which tends to make it a little frizzy.
A little? You look like the bride of Frankenstein.
Are we done making fun of my hair?
Not quite.
Your hair looks funny. Your hair looks funny.
Okay, now I'm done.
Don't worry. By the time we're done, your blind date's gonna think you're gorgeous.
Oh.
The nice man who gave us these tickets?
Another reason to hate the Yankees.
Zack, how could you be so rude?
Miss Manners, this is a baseball game. It's not your ballet class.
Mock me if you will, but I was the only boy amongst 20 pretty girls. Mama didn't raise no fool.
Slack.
Oh, not to worry. I can razz with the best of them. Hey, Yankee person! The shoelace is untied!
It's not really. I'm just saying that as a ploy.
Clever.
You swing like a girl. You're weak. You never make it as a nutcracker.
That's telling him.
Mm-hmm.
And now, please rise for the seventh inning stretch.
So, Maddie, how about I give you a facial and do your hair for your date tomorrow? We can have a little spa day in my suite.
Oh, me too. I love to ski, spend, and spa. Anything that starts with S.
Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. It'll be so nice to just for once spend a day pampering myself instead of doing what the boys want to do.
Hey, Mom, we got 3 tickets so you could take us to the game tomorrow. Won't that be fun?
It would be an opportunity for you to bond with the boys.
Oh, I shudder just thinking about it. Ooh, see? Ooh, ooh, flashback.
The more you connect with them, the less of your stuff they'll break.
You really expect me to believe that?
No. Mr. Mosby, please, 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 please. Oh. I never get a day to myself, and the boys love you.
They love me?
No. But they would if you took them to a baseball game.
I can't believe that hotel guy won't take his own kids to the baseball game.
No, no, they're not my kids.
That's just not right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, but I hate baseball.
Now, that's just un-American.
Mm-hmm. You believe this guy? I guess you hate apple pie, too, huh, fella? And puppies. And your own mama.
Sir, I love my mama. I would love to take the kids to the game. What time's kickoff?
Oh, the boys will be so thrilled. Yes.
No! Mr. Mosby at a baseball game? Those two things just don't go together. It's like Zack and